Hey everyone, welcome back to Ben on a Budget. In today's episode, we're continuing on from the Mackie DL16s wireless mixer and focusing more on some of the features of the MasterFader app, which is what you use to mix your band through this wireless mixer. So once you've connected your tablet or device to the mixer, you can then choose different shows that you've worked with. In this case, I'm just choosing a generic band that I've worked with, load it up, and then choose one of these scenes or these snapshots of some of the mixes that we've had in the past. From here, this is the mixer view that I prefer to use. There are different views that you can work with, but I particularly like this one. And what I really enjoy about this is every time you move one of the faders on this current device, if you've got multiple devices connected to the mixer, you will see those faders moving as well in real time. So everyone gets a real time update of any adjustments that are happening. If I click up here on the top, we can kind of have a look at some of the features that we can adjust and change. I can adjust the gain. I can switch between the mic preamp and the USB output. I can pan it left and right, and I can turn on or off the phantom power. From here, I can also assign different subgroups or the VCAs. I can adjust the volume of the fallbacks that I want to send it to, or the monitors, and also add effects to them. Back on this view, I can still adjust the pan left and right, so I don't always have to go to the other view. And I can mute and solo this channel just like you would on a regular analog desk. Each channel will have its own graphic EQ that you can adjust to your liking. There's different views. You can do a vintage view or a modern view. And each channel also comes with its own dynamics. So in this case, we've got a noise gate and a compressor, again, with a vintage or modern look. Now, one of the cool features I like about this is I can name or custom name every single channel to whichever instrument or person that I'm working with. I can assign a picture or an icon to represent that channel, so I've got a really quick snapshot view of what I'm working with. I can change the color, so everything's kind of grouped together in colors, or maybe I assign a color specific to an instrument or audio source. It just makes it easier to figure out what it is I'm adjusting or working with. Now, each channel can either be set up as a mono or stereo. For this first one I'm working with, I've got an MP3 player plugged into channel 15 and 16, and you can see there's two individual audio sources, one for the left and one for the right, and I have to change the faders for both of them manually, but I can link the two channels over, and now I've got a stereo channel. One of the cool features we have here is we can create mute groups, so different groups to mute different things on the mixer, such as the band or the MP3 or any of the main mixers. I can mute the auxiliary sends or the foldbacks, the monitors, or maybe I want to mute the effects. It's really easy. I love this feature because it's a really quick way to assign things. It's really easy. I just click on which group I'm working with and I just click on the channel or the item that I want to mute or assign to that group. Now, we've got six different auxiliary channels. For this example, I think I've only got three or four of them set up, and I can rename the foldback. So that could be stage left, stage right, or the drummer foldback, or any monitors. Just makes it easier to identify which musician or which foldback I'm using. And again, I can also change the color. I can change the name of it. I can assign an image or a picture. And if you're using like a tablet or a phone, you can actually take a photo using the camera and assign it to that channel. So if you're working with a band that you're unfamiliar with, you can just take a photo of whichever person you're working with and assign it to that channel. Again, just like having the other channels, I can link over two auxiliary channels to make a stereo send. So in this case, you can see auxiliary 5 and 6 have been linked over. And if I compare it to one of the other ones, which is mono, we've got a stereo, or I can unlink them and turn them back into a mono auxiliary send. Now over here with the effects, I can assign reverb or whatever effects I'm working with to different channels or different musicians that I'm working with. So I've got some chorus, delay, and reverb set up. I go to a blank one over here, nothing's really set up. And if I click up here, Mackie gives you a couple of generic default effects racks to choose from. So yeah, it's pretty easy to adjust them. They do give you some presets to work with. Personally, I find the effects rack that comes with the Mackie DL16, you know, not the best, but it does the job. You'll have to play around quite a bit to find some settings that you really like. Over here to subgroups, if you've assigned a channel to a subgroup, you can control the volume output as well as some dynamics and EQ all in one for that group. And with the VCAs, it's mainly just a voltage control, so you want to add volume to a group of them, you just use the VCAs. Now over here we've got the view groups, and basically this is kind of like a subgroup setting, but rather than adjusting the volume of every single channel that you've added to that group, it's just a view. So I like to set mine up to view each musician, so I might set up a view group for just the keyboard player or just the drummer. You know, it just makes it easier. So if I want to adjust something for just one specific person, I can view them and switch between them. Over here, these are the master faders or the master sends. So we've got our main mix, auxiliary, effects, subgroups, and VCAs. Up the top with the settings, we have access limits, which means if you've got multiple people with devices connected to the mixer, you can actually lock them out of certain features so that they don't screw up your mix. And also different other features, you can, you know, quickly adjust the mic preamps, the phantom power, and we've got some input and output routing. It does look a little bit confusing at first, but once you play around with it, it's actually pretty cool. It really helps with setting up a mix for maybe live streaming if you want to reroute the input audio source to go to a specific output. And we also have a quick mute or clear solo feature up the top here where I can just quickly adjust some things with the effects or mute and unmute or clear the solo of anything without having to go and look for each channel that I've muted or soloed. It's just a quick way to like turn it on and off. Over in this view, it's a different way to look at the mixer. I'm not really particularly fond of this view. It doesn't really kind of work for me or for what I need it to do, but once you've got your mix set up and you're already mixing, this is probably a good way to just quickly adjust channels, you know, on the fly. But I prefer this view. I like being able to see everything. Now on the main master fader and auxiliary faders, we can adjust our graphic EQ, and we've got different views for like a spectrum or an RTA. We've got some presets that we can work with. We can zoom in and zoom out of the frequency band that we're working with, or we can draw in the frequency we're working with or what we want in the room. If you didn't want to do that, you can turn off the draw button and just manually dial in what you need. There's also a compressor for each of these master channels, like the auxiliary sends and the main left and right. The dynamics come in really, really handy once you've got your mix together, and you can also assign it pre-fader or post-fader or pre-DSP, so that's before the effects are gone into it. This is helpful if you wanted to do some recording as well and you didn't want any effects, you know, in your mix, and we can pan it left and right. Now over here, this is where you can save the mix that you're working with, and you can see I've created a blank mix, or I can recall an old one. So if I'm working with the same band in the same venue that we've done in the past, I can just bring up the mix and it's already done for me, and maybe I'll tweak something here and there. So this is one band I'm working with. I can load up a generic band and recall that, and you'll see that everything's different. All the labels are different, the colors are different, the icons are different, the effects, the routing, the EQ, it's all saved for each band. Maybe if I'm running karaoke night and I'm only needing a few channels for this karaoke gig I did for a cafe, you can see I'm only using a few channels, and it's all saved, ready to go. You can take a photo or assign a logo of the band or the event that you're working with to make it easier to spot, and in the notes, just type in certain key things that you need to be reminded of about this event, like, you know, just knowing, you know, who likes what setup where on the stage, or any particular routing or effects or something that's happening mid-show, if there's any notes you need to add. And I can either create a whole new show from the spot, or I can import or export my shows and then save them to the cloud, so I've always got a backup and I can load them in, you know, if let's say my tablet crashes, I've always got a backup. This is what it looks like on a cell phone. So this is on my iPhone, and you can see it does look similar to some extent, but it does lack some features, mainly because it's on a cell phone. And it's not that the phone can't keep up with the requirements or the software requirements. It's actually to do with the size of the screen. And this was confirmed to me by one of the tech guys from Mackie, who I inquired about this to see if we could get more of the features on it. But he said, no, it's something to do with the size of the screen. So just like if I was using the tablet or a PC, I can scroll across the mixer, I can mute, I can pan left and right, and I can change the colors, the icons, just all the basic stuff that you need. But what you can't adjust is the phantom power and the gain. That's usually done on like a tablet. So if I move the faders up and down on my phone, it will move on any other device that's connected, whether it's a laptop or a tablet or some other phone. With the view groups, again, if I just want to view certain channels that I need, so let's say I'm doing a gig, I'm the guitarist on stage, and I only want to adjust my mix, then I would only want to view myself in the view groups rather than everyone else, because I've got a small phone that I'm working with compared to a tablet, so I don't need to see everyone else's one. So with a cell phone, you don't have to look at it in portrait view. You can turn the phone sideways and get a landscape view, and you'll get a bigger range of channels to work with at first glance. And this might be handy for someone who's got lots of channels that they're using. Maybe you're a drummer, you've got multiple mics set up for your drums, and you wanna adjust your monitor mix for your in-ear monitors or speaker that's sitting next to you. But for the most part, I try and put mine in portrait mode. Keeps it pretty discreet on stage. Now, that was a lot for me to cover all in one. That is a really, really rough guide to some of the features. But if you go onto YouTube, there is a ton of resources from other users, and they go into it a lot more in depth. What I really love about Mackie is what they do really well is they interact and work with the community really well, and they upload a lot of content. They are really onto it, and I am absolutely amazed at, you know, how quickly they can respond to me about my questions and just the helpful information that they put together. So make sure to check it out. If you want a full in-depth tutorial, check out Mackie TV. They have a webinar series and they deep dive into the MasterFader app and all the different features that you can do with the DL line wireless mixers. I highly recommend you check it out, but I watched this several times because it was so helpful. And I got to give credit to the CJ and the team at Mackie. They are awesome, fantastic guys. One of the main reasons why I chose to go with Mackie is mainly because of the user interface of the app. I personally found the MasterFader app for Mackie, it looks a lot more user-friendly. Like to be honest, it kind of looks very Mickey Mouse. It looks really kid-friendly, I guess, with all the colors. And you know, I didn't want to use an app that looks intimidating. Like if I compare it to this one, yeah, I mean, the Soundcraft one has some colors as well, and the faders kind of look a little bit more realistic on what you'd find on an analog desk. But I don't know, I just found some of the icons, you know, like smaller icons kind of intimidate some people that I've worked with in the past, and they just freak out and they don't like, you know, doing anything with it. So that's why I went with the MasterFader app. The one thing I don't like about the MasterFader app is sometimes it's actually hard to tell what is a button and what is actually just like, I don't know, like an image or an icon. If I were to compare it to one of the other mixers like the Soundcraft, you can clearly tell what is a button, what you can push and what you can't push. With the MasterFader app, I mean, it does look a lot more, you know, easier to work with, but it just would have been cool if the buttons were a little bit more defined or kind of had like a 3D look, so you know it's like a button to push. Another example, the Behringer wireless mixer. Again, a lot of similar features. You've got faders, you've got EQ, everything that I kind of briefly touched on with the MasterFader app, you can definitely find in the Xair app from Behringer. And you know, like I said, Mackie just looked a little bit more friendly to work with. If you want to try this one out, you can download the app for free from the Behringer website and just mess around with it. Although you're not going to get the full grasp of how it works and all the features without actually having the wireless mixer that goes with it. All these other wireless mixers, they look very similar in design. Mackie DL16s mixer, and same with the applications, the apps, they do the same thing. You can save your mixes, you can create custom and presets and mute, solo, pan left and right, adjust the gain, adjust the EQ, dynamics. They all do the same thing. Some just have a couple more features, and some of them, you know, where one does really well in one department, the other, you know, not so much, but then they make up for it with other things. Some of them just have a different layout, and others have a more friendlier, kid-friendly looking layout and more color versus less color. It really comes down to personal preference. Okay, it's really up to you. If you're not sure which one to invest or buy in, look, I can honestly tell you, because I've worked with Behringer before and I've worked with Allen&Heath wireless mixers, I can honestly tell you they all do the same thing, so you can't go wrong with that. They all have the same features. Maybe one of them has a better effects DSP, some of them just have better way of managing the inputs and outputs, but really it comes down to personal preference. So don't worry too much about it, just download the apps, try them out, see which one is more suited for you. I hope this was helpful. And that's all for today, guys. Hope that was helpful. Stay tuned for some more Simplify Your Setup and other reviews here on Band on a Budget. Thanks.